Away from that, annually, Uganda registers 34% of the girls that are forced into early marriage prior to celebrating their 18th birthday, which is punishable according to the Uganda's laws. In Ankole region, some parents continue to forcefully give away their girls to commence family affairs with men who qualify to be their fathers. In our tonight's exclusive report titled Sending On Offspring Into Marriage Captivity, Halson Kagure investigates the persistent vice in districts of Karuhira and Kazo and what it means for the country. We have the details.
She shall be called woman because she was taken out of a man. Therefore, a man leaves his father's house and his mother and cleaves to his wife, and they become one flesh. The above extract from Genesis chapter 2 verses 24, which qualifies marriage as a public covenant between a man and woman, is not portrayed in this video clip. This video, said to have been filmed in Kirihura, shows a bride being forced into marriage in remote areas of Rishere sub-county, where our investigations began. We landed on another victim whose name is withheld. This happened in 2011, when she was only 16, but the marriage did not take place instantly. In a sober-like mode, she recounts the time when she lost her first set of pregnancies. Here, we also established that some girls who tend to be stubborn are either kidnapped and parents would pick dowries later.
It's part of the culture. You see, this culture of ours is very expensive. And the norms and the rules that governs marriage are still a little bit difficult. What do I mean? They decide to have a shortcut. That's the most important to me.
I'm telling you, where you find that the LC chairperson of the area you want to use is relative to the other person. So it is very hard to be given information from such a person. That's why we use common sense to get information. It is not true on what you have interviewed me that they are denying, rather we are failing to get information. We are getting information, that's why we are arresting those people.
As the moon sets in, sources direct us to Grace Nayebari, another anonymous victim of forced marriage. Grace is now struggling to raise her two-year-old boy alone and is being viewed as a marriage failure. Samantha, her village mate, managed to complete primary 7 at Parents Academy Community School in Kazo District.
We have had some cases where we have early marriages, we have early pregnancies, and these things bring poverty into a family. We know we have already have families which have generation to generation poverty, and we all come from one or two.
He's now agitating for adult education to tackle the resistant vice.
That means he/she has moved the level from literacy level to understanding what can help a child. And this means they have also learned through these small scale projects I've told you. They have learned how to grow like tomatoes, onions. I created market for them at the school. I told them whoever grows anything, I will buy them.
15-year-old Scovia Tumahari was infected by a man identified as Edson Mujenye, who was later arrested but never tried due to COVID-19. The suspect's family has been trying to negotiate with police to set him free, and it would later call for intervention of Center for Women and Justice Uganda.
The family is threatening the girl with death. That's why we are where we are. The girl is in hiding. We hope they don't locate it. Her security is an issue. But the mother who has stayed in the community is being threatened with banishment. Now, after they've put that much pressure, they are proposing an amicable arrangement to compensate them.
2018 survey by Girls Not for Pride Uganda found out that annually over 35% of teenage girls are lured into marriage.
And when it came to COVID, basically some poor people and poor in terms of riches and poor in terms of thinking, if I can say, so that they would withdraw their children from school and marry them off. Those of you who come from Kazo, you are aware we have restrained 4 girls from being married off.
This evil that saw 9 girl pupils in Kazo district miss out on primary leaving exams is blamed on quest for bride wealth.
It is the culture of our people. They don't bother about the future of the girl. It is just a culture. A person, he sees 10 heads of cattle as much for him or for her, for his or for her. For his girl or daughter. That's the culture.
So the fear that the Banyankore have traditionally is that you'd rather marry off your daughter than the child producing the child here. It is more of an abomination of that producing a child before you are married. So it is better the parent says, I would rather give my child in marriage than this child producing here. It is a sort of a preventive measure to produce these unwanted pregnancies and these other children that are born out of the wedlocks.
We have since established that majority of perpetrators are as old as father's victims, but police rarely arrest them.
Once they know that this girl always pass here at 6 a.m. or at 6 p.m., they time that person on the way. They just grab. They don't tell her that we want to take you. When they grab, they very fast go and inform the parents that we have taken your girl. We are ready to give cows or goats.
These pay as many as 12 cows as bride price at a lavish ceremony presided by graced men of God. Though North Ankole Bishop dismisses allegations.
Whoever marries a girl who is underage will be defrocked. We have, as church, the North Ankole Diocese, made practical actions in order to reduce early marriages and early pregnancies. We have built a girl's secondary school.
I wrote the bishop telling him that he should not allow his the parish priest to marry any girl who is underage. I did it. We arrested even a pastor who married a girl who was underage. We have been arresting people on weddings.
Forced marriage evil has been intensified by COVID-19 pandemic lockdown.
So if we had 10,000 teenage pregnancies in the first lockdown, how many teenage pregnancies are we going to have? And that was particular to the region. So, yes, it is preventive to close schools, but also it is dangerous in many ways. And we are going back.
at Timbara Regional Referral, over 428 cases of adolescent pregnancies were captured since lockdown, as national figures put it at 25%. This persistent vice has attracted the attention of a group of youths under their umbrella, Kazo Hope Organization, which aims at fighting the vice.
That we shall keep beggars, beggars until, because you will not support yourself when you are not educated. You will keep a beggar at any time you are married off. You will again come back to your parents' home, seek for help, either to make up your family or to do anything.
The parent doesn't mind. For them, what they are minding about, it's getting bars of soap, it's getting sugar, it's getting posho, and what to feed their children. But they forget that a sanitary pad, just as simple as it is, it may make this girl susceptible to such unfortunate scenario.
Uganda is still ranked among the nations with high cases of early marriages, though Barra University gender scholars argue that it has fused into arranged marriages to mature girls at the university level.
I was defiled by my father.
Story by Halson Kagure for the news.